Hi, it's Dwyer, gamblersadvisory.com, dwyervip.com. On Roku, the vanity code is Dwyer Boxing News. On iTunes, same thing, Dwyer Boxing News, one word. Remember, the opinion you should follow should be your own. Just consider this video to be a second opinion from a complete stranger online. There's an article today, in BoxingScene.com, where British promoter Eddie Hearn, one of the foremost promoters in the sport, expresses his belief that Amir Khan will easily beat Devin Alexander. Right? Let me tell you, I'm on the other side of this play. I'm a bit bewildered as to what people are thinking. I don't know what Amir Khan is thinking here. I thought he was going to fight Robert Guerrero. A fight where his foot speed would rule the day. Here, he's fighting a guy who, quite frankly, is a better chess player than him. Right? He's fighting a guy who, let's be clear here, when Devin Alexander beat Marcus Maidana, I want you to go through YouTube and find that post-fight interview. Right? Marcus Maidana thought he beat Floyd Mayweather the first time he fought him. He had no such delusions when he lost to Devin Alexander. That was a lopsided fight. Let me say too, understand, you know, Alexander, who moved against Marcus Maidana, is one of those disciplined fighters who can fight guys with very big punches and somehow not get distracted, follow the game plan, and never get caught with his opponent's Sunday punch, right? Go through the Alexander record, and you're going to see that after he lost to Timothy Bradley, he fought three guys with some of the biggest punches in the weight class. Right, Lucas Matisse, Marcus Maidana, and Randall Bailey. Now, I know in the Matisse fight, close fight, I know Matisse caught him and dropped him. But what's noteworthy is the fact that Alexander goes the full 10 rounds with Matisse. Right, big puncher, huge puncher. Nonetheless, Alexander is disciplined to the point where he goes the distance with Matisse and wins a split decision, right? Marcus Maidana, he goes the distance with Maidana. Understand, the closest scorecard for that 10-round fight was Alexander winning 99-91. He goes the distance with Randall Bailey. Understand, the Bailey fight is a 12-round fight. Bailey's nickname is the Knockout King. When you see a boxer repeatedly in against big punchers, and he's able to box these big punchers and go the distance against them, right? Dominating Maidana and Bailey, surviving Lucas Matisse. To me, that tells you that this guy is a tactician. The kind of fighters who trouble Devin Alexander style-wise are guys who can fight inside, guys who get up on him, who can fight low and get underneath his guard and bother him, guys who can put a head on his chest. The two times he's lost, the first was to Timothy Bradley, right? A fight that featured some alleged headbutts. The second was to Sean Porter, right? But understand, those guys can get inside and can rough you up. When is the last time you saw Amir Khan do that? I don't think you have, right? Amir Khan really is an athlete with great hand speed and great foot speed. He's a guy who dances around the ring, picks his spots, is able to beat you by jumping in with combinations. He's not a guy who stays at the chessboard, right? Who is out boxing you while standing in front of you. Right? Nor is he a guy who can jump inside like a Timothy Bradley and have his head so close to your head that it's in the way. That's not Amir Khan's game, right? He's also not a Sean Porter guy who's bouncing, right? And then can, from outside, jump in and then stay inside. That's what Porter can do. Amir Khan is an ambush fighter, but then he ends the ambush and backs back out, right? That kind of style, to me, is not going to be that effective against Devin Alexander. Right, understand too, Alexander's very different than Robert Guerrero. Yes, they're both southpaws, but Alexander's a fast southpaw. Understand, both Alexander and Amir Khan have above average hand speed. Right, so my point to you is simply this. If Devin Alexander was able to fight hard punchers, right, like Matisse, Maidana, and Bailey. By the way, he fought them back to back. Just food for thought. As you look at the Matisse fight, and I know he didn't look his best in that fight, just understand that's the first fight he had after his first career loss. Now, if Devin Alexander was able to go the distance against all of those guys, why should anyone believe that he's not going to be able to handle Amir Khan's punch? Right? Understand, too, Devin is a guy who's accustomed to fighting rough and tumble guys. Right? Guys who want to turn it into a brawl. His last fight was a win over Jesus Soto Caraz. Right? Devin Alexander is not going to be, Amir Khan is not going to be in the pocket causing the kind of in-the-pocket problems that a Jesus Soto Caraz is going to cause. So what you have here is a fight where a boxing match might break out, right? Because Devin can move. Now, if a boxing match breaks out, who do you feel more comfortable with? I feel more comfortable with Devin Alexander. I think he's a live underdog here. Understand, with Alexander, you're getting 2-1 odds. He is the underdog, right? If I had to hedge the play, and it's a difficult fight to hedge, I would hedge Alexander, the 2-1 underdog, to win the fight with the over in the match, whatever that is. Why? Because if you go through Amir Khan's history, you're going to notice that skilled boxers, think Julio Diaz, right? Think Lamont Peterson. Skilled boxers are able to go several rounds with Amir Khan, right? Both of those guys went the distance with Amir Khan. In my opinion, Devin Alexander is a skilled boxer. If you can't get on his chest like Bradley or Porter, you're going to have problems. For a guy who wanted to fight Floyd Mayweather, I am shocked that Amir Khan decided to take this fight. I'm guessing in St. Louis, when the phone rang and the Devin Alexander people picked up the phone and got offered this fight, I'm guessing they accepted before they even heard the details of when and where. This is a great fight for Devin Alexander, in my opinion. Just be aware of the fact that there are boxing insiders, guys who know the players and who, you know, have talked with the players, people like Eddie Hearn, who think differently. But style-wise, a slick southpaw. That's what Devin is. He's slick. Right? Fast hand speed. Can move when he needs to. Look at him dance around Marcus Maidana. Right? This kind of southpaw, to me, is a bad matchup for Amir Khan. If you look at Amir Khan, he's a little bit stiff at the neck. right? He gets caught up in the moment. I believe he's the opposite of Devin Alexander. I think Alexander can fight a Randall Bailey. He knows Bailey has a big punch. He knows not to walk into it. There's nothing Bailey can do to throw Devin Alexander off his game. Look at the CompuBox numbers for that fight. Right? Alexander is disciplined. Contrast that with Amir Khan, who I get the feeling gets caught up in the crowd, gets caught up in the moment, makes mistakes in fights. I like Devin Alexander here. I think he's a live dog. I'll hedge the play with the over. Let me hear from you. Leave your comments for me here online. Visit us at gamblersadvisory.com. Thanks for stopping by.